Today is another scratch foam play day. Unlike the first video where we drew a design on the scratch foam and then used it as a print plate, today we're going to print positive images. I'm going to show you how to do a quick mono print, and I'm also going to show you how you can use scratch foam in a technique that kind of resembles what you would do with an unmounted rubber stamp. There's lots of different things that you can do with scratch foam, so stick around and I'll show you how. When you think about using scratch foam as a print plate, what probably comes to mind is to take your design and draw it on here with something like this ball stylus. It creates a depression in the foam that you're going to then ink up and print. And I'm going to show you that quickly once, just in case you haven't seen the other video. Because we're going to be printing with acrylic paint, which is water-based, that means you're going to have to mix something in it to stop it from drying so soon. And in that case, I'm going to use Golden's acrylic glazing liquid. I'm going to use probably the same amount as I did of paint, and this is going to extend the drying and the working time and allow me to work with this so that it's not drying as I'm trying to brayer it out and to print with it. I'm just going to ink up the brayer so that there's even coverage on it. All right, now that this is inked up, what I'm going to do is take a piece of paper and I'm going to mist it lightly with water. That's just going to help the paint to adhere. And it's as simple as putting this on here and pressing down. And then you lift up. And there's your image. Now, this was a little bit too wet, I can see, because I'm rushing to try to get through this, but that's the basics. What you get is a white outline of a tree. You've got a purple tree and a purple background, which is nice, but I have some ideas that are going to be even nicer. What I've done is I've taken that same tree and I traced it onto scratch foam with my ball stylus, but then rather than really make that impression, I went in with some scissors and I cut out the trunk and I cut out the top of the tree. I'm going to print with these now in such a way that the body of the tree and the top of the tree are actually going to be colored and the background of the paper is going to remain white. I marked both of them with the back so that I don't confuse these and print the opposite side, because then things are not going to line up. This is a very simple design, and the only place where any alignment is going to happen is just where the trunk attaches to the top of the tree. But if you have something that's a little bit more intricate, you do need to be careful about printing on the correct side. So let me ink this up and then I'll show you what we get. And I'm going to print this in such a way that I leave room for the trunk. Press this down. Now I'm going to print all in purple, but obviously you're open to being able to use many more colors if you want to, and you could get a brown trunk if you wanted. And then it's just a question of coming in and putting this where it belongs. And printing. This is the print I did a moment ago, and I like this. There's some variation in the intensity of the color. There was a little bit more water in spots, and the paint didn't adhere quite as well. That's great. It adds some interest. But think about how much more interesting this would be if there were some other designs on this tree. For example, let's say that I wanted, here's another one. This is a different piece, but let's say that I wanted to make some circles on here to represent an apple. I have this template with all these various sizes of circles on it. And so I'm going to trace a couple of these on here, and then I'm going to cut them out, and then I'll print with this, and you'll see the difference. And you could make these apples, and you can make different sizes if you want. I guess the point is that there's a variety of things that you can do with this. You don't have to have a solid print. There we go. There's apples on our apple tree now, or circles on your circle tree, whatever you want it to be. So the next step is going to be to print this and the trunk, and I will show you a still photo of that. It'll be posted on the page along with the video, and you can see what this looked like. In the opening, I mentioned I was going to show you how you can use scratch foam so it works more or less like an unmounted rubber stamp. I have three pieces here that I cut out of the foam. One is a heart, there's a circle, and there's just this sort of indeterminate border that I scribbled out. It really is that simple. Draw with your template or just with your stylus tool on the scratch foam, cut it out, and then you can print with it. Now, something that's as small as this little circle, you're going to have to work with a little handle or something like that. This is just a piece of polymer clay. If you push it out in the back, once you condition it, you can pick that up and it becomes a little bit easier to use. And for something like this, you can put a couple of pieces on, and again, it becomes a little bit easier to use. Now, these are not going to last forever, but you certainly can work with them, and they're very inexpensive to make, and you can make any design that you want. Working with these is very similar to what we did before. I'm just picking up some different color paint now. I've already mixed this. With the glazing medium. Here's the heart. Again, very simple. And of course, my fingers are painty, so I'm getting paint everywhere that I don't want it to be. But you see how simple it is to go ahead and print this. Sometimes you want to stamp an image around the edge of a page or as a border or something along those lines, and no matter how carefully you think you're going along and you want to stamp this image on here, by the time you get back to the beginning, nothing lines up. And in some cases, that's not a bad thing. If you're doing something that's a very loose edge, then that's great, and I've done that with this stamp in the past. But if the part of you that says, no, this must be perfect kicks in, then I have a solution for you, and it involves using scratch foam. What you can do is get a piece of scratch foam that's cut to the approximate size of the page you want to work on, and you're going to trace a design on here. And in this case, I'm going to find my little stylus, and I'm going to finish tracing the design. And there's no rhyme or reason to what I did here. It's just some little swoopy curly things. What I'm going to do now is cut this out, and so I'm left with this outer border, and then I'll print with it and show you what we get. All right, my border template, also known as pretend unmounted rubber stamp, is all set to go, so I'm going to ink up my brayer. I cut this piece of paper to match the size of the scratch foam. We'll have some bigger scratch foam, which will make the options of sizes of pages that you can use a little bit larger. Let me clean up this mess. I'm going to give this a little spritz. I can tell that I didn't line that up perfectly, but it's close enough for hand grenades and government work here. You get the point of what I'm trying to do. Just give that a press. And I think I'm going to flip it over to lift it up. And there's the piece. Traditionally, a monoprint is a printmaking technique where paint is applied to a piece of glass or a piece of plexiglass, and then paper or fabric is put on it and printed once. Mono meaning one print. I think you can do that with scratch foam. In fact, I'm going to try that for you right now, and we'll see what happens. I'm going to take just a plain piece of scratch foam, and I'm going to brush some paint on there. I'm going to use a cotton swab and I'm just going to draw some designs in here. And this is nothing special, nothing fancy, it's just a way to play, and you could certainly get quite more creative than I'm doing here, but nevertheless, it gives you the idea of how you can create a monoprint using scratch foam. Now the difference between this and when you would ordinarily draw a design on here is that I did not press into the scratch foam, so though there's a pattern that emerged from the design that I used the Q-tip to put on in the paint, there's no pressure that was applied to the scratch foam, and so once this is cleaned off, like any print plate, it could be used again and you could put more paint on here and then pull another print from it. So again, there's a monoprint pulled from scratch foam.